Hey everybody, my name's Cam Forrester, and this is How to Play Venus in Furs by the Velvet Underground. Now this is going to be the first in a series of videos about how to play songs by this group, and other groups in the future, so please make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also check out my own original music which is on there, and click the notification bell so that you get notified in the future when videos come out. Now I've been into the Velvet Underground since I was around 12 years old, which is when I first started learning to play the drums. And in the first book that I ever got about learning to play the drums, there was a segment on Maureen Tucker, a very small section which just explained who she was and what band she was from, and also the fact that she had some unusual playing techniques as they were described. And this really intrigued me, also the fact that she was the first female drummer that I'd ever seen before. So I went out and bought their first album, and as other fans of the Velvet Underground I'm sure will be able to relate to, their music was a complete revelation to me. In particular, this song, Venus in Furs. Now the version of Venus in Furs that most of us know and love is actually the second recording of Venus in Furs by the Velvet Underground. The original recording, known as the Acetate version, was recorded in 1966 at Scepter Studios in New York.
Shiny, shiny boots of leather, whiplash girl child in the dark. Crumbs and bells, your servant don't foresee.
This early recording was recorded in the key of C, although the recording itself is slightly flat and runs somewhere between B and C. It had a muddier and more raw sound to it, and was overall less dramatic and intense sounding than the second recording, which was made in Hollywood at TTG Studios after some assistance from Tom Wilson, who was a record producer who used to work at Columbia Records, who had moved to MGM Verve. He was enthusiastic about the group and decided to try and help them refine some of their more prominent songs. The new recording was much better balanced and clear overall, and put more emphasis on Lou Reed's vocals and Cale's savage-sounding viola, both of which were much lower in the mix on the earlier version. It was recorded slightly higher in pitch this time, just below concert pitch C-sharp, which I personally feel benefited the overall sound of the recording and gave it a more menacing feel. In my own cover version of the song, I've recorded at concert pitch C-sharp, so just slightly sharper than the original album recording, using either the same or similar equipment to that recording, which is a Gretsch Country Gentleman hollow body electric guitar through a Vox amplifier, a Fender 1962 reissue precision bass, and a 1950s Premier drum kit, which has a similar shell construction to the American Gretsch round badge drums that Maureen Tucker was using at the time. Having the same or similar instruments, obviously, before you even do any mixing, makes a massive difference to replicating the sound from any recording. The only exception that I've had to make for that is the viola, of course, because I don't play or own a viola, so I've had to transcribe John Cale's parts as best I can and play them using the samples on this Nord Electro 6D. In terms of performance, I've tried to mimic as closely as possible the performances of each individual instrument on the album version, but I've also made a couple of cleanups in certain places, which I'll explain further in the tutorial. Now, the tuning that was used for Venus in Furs has actually been the subject of much debate over the years by musicians and fans alike. It's often believed that ostrich tuning was what was used, which is a tuning that Lou Reed used on an early recording whilst he was working for Pickwick Records, which was called The Ostrich. Actually, that's not the case, as the only time that he actually used ostrich tuning with the Velvet Underground on a recording was when they recorded the song All Tomorrow's Parties, in which case every string on his guitar was tuned to D at different octaves. Now, the Velvet Underground's standard go-to tuning was D, G, C, F, A, D. And the reason for this is that Cale's viola's range was much better suited to that tuning rather than the standard guitar tuning of E, A, D, G, B, E. Also, it possibly better matched Lou Reed's vocal range too, and overall it just gave the band a different sound and a much warmer and richer tone to a lot of their records. So, the actual tuning that was used on the album version of Venus in Furs is as follows. D sharp, G sharp, C sharp, F sharp, A sharp and another C sharp. So that's basically the same intervals as standard tuning, but the bottom string is tuned down two semitones. When the band played the song live, they would usually play it in C rather than C sharp. The C sharp seems to only be something that happened on the album recording. And you can actually hear on a recording of the band playing the song live at the Valleydale Ballroom in 1966, where after finishing, Lou Reed actually tunes his bottom string back up from C to D, restoring it to the Velvet Underground standard tune. So, now we have our tuning, let's play Venus in Furs. The introduction of Venus in Furs is basically a D shape. So, a normal standard D chord. However, on the bottom string for the first chord, you remove the middle finger. And then you add it. And then you add what would normally be the way you would suspend a D chord. So use your fourth finger. So that's the introduction. Now the verse section of the song consists of a picked melody. And this revolves around moving your index finger and your third finger up and down on the strings. Now to play that, you basically play your D shape with the middle finger removed, and then move your index finger up one string, and then remove your third finger. And then you move to this striking, what sounds like a dominant seventh chord, with that C-sharp bass note underneath it. It's actually a C-sharp minor 7 flat 9. So the next chord that comes in straight after that one is what would be on a standard tuned guitar, an A minor 7 chord shape. So the way that all comes together, now the next part of the verse is basically exactly the same, however the A minor 7 shape at the end becomes a standard A shape. Now Lou Reed would actually usually bend this chord upon playing it. Sometimes he would do that with his fingers, sometimes he would do it with a Bigsby tremolo arm. Personally I prefer to do it with the Bigsby because it makes it a lot more accentuated and dramatic. So basically that's the verse. So here it is all together. Last bit there, he would just go back to the D shape with the middle finger removed and just pluck those last two strings to go back into the intro section. So for the chorus, it's basically an F shape. However, of course, in this tuning, it comes out as a dominant seventh. Then you would move to what would normally be in standard tuning a B flat shape. So now this next chord is basically played as a normal C shape in any standard tune guitar again. However, in this tuning it comes out as a B7 sharp 9. Now this chord is actually my own addition to the song. At that time, Lou Reed's guitar playing wasn't as strong as it later became. He was developing and he was self-taught as well, so in his own admission, his early playing in the Velvet Underground wasn't the most musical, shall we say, in the technical sense. which was never a problem because their songs were generally fairly simple to play. However, in this particular moment in this song, the chord that he would usually play, it kind of clashed a little bit, and I think Lou Reed knew that because he would try and avoid hitting his bottom strings and playing those high sort of harmonics there. So he would usually just play the first couple. So the reason I add in that chord that matches John Cale's viola is it just fits more musically and sounds better to my personal ears, but that is not how it was originally played, so I just wanted to let you know that. So the chorus continues. Straight back into the intro section. So that's basically Venus in Furs. There's no other changes in it. Everything is just repeated. However, at the end of the song, rather than playing the intro section, Lou Reed actually doubled up on the guitar. In fact, tripled up. He played triplets over the progression of the song, so it would sound something like this. And that's it. That's how to play Venus in Furs. So I really hope you enjoyed that tutorial. If you've got any questions about the song, please feel free to let me know in the comments. And also let me know what you thought of the tutorial and any criticisms that I could take on board for future videos. That would be really helpful. And I hope to bring you another video very soon. Thank you very much.
Child in the dark comes and bells. Your servant, don't forsake him. Strike, dear mistress, and cure his heart. Down he sins of street-like fancies. Chase the costumes she shall wear. Her mind first adorned, imperious. Severin, Severin, awaits you there. Different colors made of tears. Kiss the boot of shiny, shiny leather. Shiny leather. In the dark, tongue of thorns, the belt that does await you. strike, dear mistress, and cure his heart. Severin, Severin, speak so slightly. Severin, down on your bended knees. Taste the whip, little love not given lightly. Taste the whip, now believe for me. Tired, I am weary. I could sleep for 1,000 years, 1,000 dreams that would awake me. Different colors made of tears. Whiplash girl, child in the dark. Severin, your servant comes in bells, please don't forsake him.